Okay, this is Lynda Cromar and I'm back again. This video will probably wrap up the majority of the rest of these steps. And the reason why I broke it down like this is because I want to make sure you're set up correctly before you go to the next step. Because sometimes people are in a great big hurry to get an ad out there and then they just put things in there that doesn't really help them. So that's why I spent a lot of time explaining how to get the really cool ad that gets people's attention. And I have two examples. You saw this one being created, and then this one also, which is one of my favorites. And I use it all the time because it really gets their attention. And of course, as you can see by looking at it, part of it has to do with the way I've done the text. I've purposely made it kind of fun by not making it completely symmetrical. I've got a couple of slanty pieces of text. You can't do that in that other program unless I think you can do it in the premium version, or you can do like I have and get Photoshop. You can actually get it online for a real low mint monthly fee of I think it's $10 a month, and pretty much really worth it if you want to do some really cool graphics. You don't have to do fancy stuff. But anyway, either way you go, the setup, the getting the ad ready is the major piece that needs to happen, because if you're getting the kind of reaction that I'm generally getting from these ads, that's the whole point, right? You want to get the reaction. And this one didn't set as well with the text, no spaces in there. I like to put spaces because it's easier to read. You got to remember that 65 to 70% of the people that are on Facebook are on there from a mobile device, generally a cell phone, and their screen is going to be smaller. So you want to make it something that they can see. So I made this text really large. I didn't use a huge amount of text. You're not trying to get a lot of information on just that part. You're just going to give them a teaser so they want to know more, because the whole point is you want them to message you. Especially if you're starting out at the very beginning, you're not looking to put a link here, because if you do, there's a good chance that they will just look at the link and they'll go away. So on this other one that I did, you'll notice I have that I want them to message me. And I actually told them that I expect them to message me or they're not going to get the information. And so that's the point. Now, the next thing I do, generally first thing in the morning and then one more time maybe in the evening, is you see this world up here? I click that and then I come all the way down here to where it says See All and I click that. And by doing that, I open up a whole page that shows my notifications. Now, why do I want to do that? Obviously, we're getting notifications all day long of all kinds of things, and this lets me see where I'm actually getting some response from my ads, and then I can respond to them, right? Now, when you're very beginning, you probably could go ahead and actually message them, but I suggest you don't do it very long, because what we really want is for them to come to us. That's all about attraction marketing. So here I've got somebody messaged me. She commented on a photo. Let's go see. Sometimes it's a comment like I want information, and sometimes it's them spamming. So I don't know yet. I haven't looked at it. So here we are in this group. And yes, she's looking for information, but as you can see, she just wrote info, please. She expects me to message her. And even though I said right here, message me now. Now, I have a file inside a VIP lounge that is my Enviralizer, Eric Worre. This is my version of Eric Worre, his specific things that he teaches in his book. And I put it in there for everybody. But for my benefit and for my convenience, I also have it on a little dock that I can use all the time. And so I have several little messages already here that I can use. to contact, to let them know that they need to talk to me directly or they're not going to get the information. They either can email me or they can send me a message on Facebook. They have one of those two choices. So that's the first thing I do every morning is I do that. And then if it's just one person, I try whenever possible to tag them. And there she comes up. So let's go ahead and tag it. So by tagging it, the whole purpose of that is that they're going to get a notification up there in that world box. Remember, they're going to get a notification that they just got a response from what they put here. And then I'm also going to like. If I like, what happens? This is kind of a cool little inside thing. It boosts this picture post up to the top of the stream of that group. So I'm going to like it and I'm going to comment. I'm not going to go message her because I want her to come to me. That's really important. So I'm going to do this to anyone that has commented on my posts. And there's only a few because I've usually stay on top of this. So here's another one. And like I said, I'm going to do this in the morning. As you can see, this one has gotten a lot of attention. But look at how many people are just on this one. If I tried to message these people, Facebook only allows you to do about maybe 10 people. And so you would miss being able to help people. And the fact that, and I've already done it, and I don't know why I did it twice. I need to delete that second one. So it's a very important to do this. As you can see, I've done this. I've like, and I need to like whenever possible theirs, because the reason why is they're going to get a notification up here. So I only had a couple of those to show you, but that is important. And if I were to count how many people, and I also don't do their emails if they put it up here. If they haven't sent me an email to my email account, then they're not going to get the information. And I'm being stinky, maybe a little bit, because I'm not going to chase all these people. And I want them to follow directions. And I put the directions very explicitly, both on the picture and on the text. So it says, ask me how. And it says up here, I will only share with those who send me a message. If I've put this up here and they still don't get it, then they must not need it that badly. And I'm not going to show you the actual emails coming to me, but I want to suggest one thing that's very important. Have a email that is only for this purpose. Because you're going to get inundated and you don't want to miss somebody that actually did send you a message. So I set up a special one that is just in the, I set up a special one that is just in mail.com and it is only for the purpose of doing these ads. So any of my other emails, and I have more than one, are not going to get inundated with, messages and then get lost possibly because I have it set up in such a way that I want them to send it to this specific email only. If they find another email and they send it there, I won't see it. So that's really important. Then step number two is that you're going to want to see if I can get into the messages that are already here. take a minute for it to open because I had so many windows open. So as you can see, I have these messages earlier done, and then you have to come in here once in a while and you have to check because you're going to find that people are messaging you frequently for information. And right now I'm caught up, but specifically in the Eric Worre version, I have you set up to basically say two different things, and I have this on purpose. This is directly from Eric Worre. What I'm saying to him is, okay, and I give and make sure to type his name correctly, whoever it is, and if it's a really crazy name that you're not sure you can type, then don't put anything there at all. Better not to have a name than to type it incorrectly. So the first part is I tell him I want him to watch a video. I ask him if he will. He comes back and says, okay. Then I give him the video. And the video, remember, is a capture page. They have to opt in first. That's how I get my 20 leads, more than 20, pretty much every single day. And the reason why is because they get the capture page. So I've got three things that are happening. I have that they have to come in here and they have to message me, and I remind them on the post, but I don't go chasing them. And then that's number one, they have to message me. Number two, I ask them, will you watch the video? And I have a specific language, and I suggest you use this exactly as I have it here. It's very important that you follow instructions. If I give you a video, will you watch it? That is directly from Eric Worre. And then I get a yes or no. And if they say no, I don't argue with them. I say, okay, great, have a great day. And sometimes they'll say, well, don't you have that in text, or can't you just give me a quick explanation? And generally, I'll say, no, are you ready for the video? And then I say on the second part after they say yes, hey, perfect. And you need to make this sound like you. So change this word so it sounds like you. If this is not a word you use, change it. And then I say, go watch this and then we will talk. Any questions, hold till you watch it, because it will answer most of them. Again, you can change this a little, but keep the basic information in there. And I will be here after you watch it. Then, like I said, they get a capture page. Now, you know, this guy is actually really pretty responsive because he said okay twice. Now, I know a lot of people talk about follow up and follow up and follow up. I don't do a lot of that in Facebook because I've found that it's kind of not working that well. But I have a whole email series set up where they're getting the emails as a follow-up after they get into this and after they've opted in. And I'm going to know if they opted in because I could actually go check by looking at my email, that same email I showed you, that see if they actually did. And if they didn't, if they're trying to get around that, I don't let them. I say, you know, I had somebody today that said, well, can't you just give me the direct video? Well, if you do that, you never have a way of finding out if they even looked at it. And then you want them to become leads because generally there's two kinds of people. There's two people. There's one that's going to say, yes, I want this right now, and they join immediately. But the larger percentage generally want to think about it and they don't do it immediately. They want to figure out who you are a little bit. And so they're going to get on your list and they're going to see your emails and you're going to send them daily broadcasts as well. And so that's how I follow up and that's how I close a lot of the time because they're going to see my emails both about this product and about training that we share all the time and other kinds of value that I share, like my blog. So that's how I close. I actually get it to a point where they're learning about me and they decide they want to join me. And I had somebody join just this week exactly from that process. He said yes because he had been watching my emails, he'd been reading all of the stuff that I have been sharing, and he decided he wanted to be part of it. And he is from Iceland. So, I mean, it any place in the world where they allow PayPal, that could be somebody that actually joins. And so I try not to be prejudiced because I don't know if they are going to be a good candidate or not. I'm not going to make that judgment. I'm just going to give them the information and I'm going to let them see it. And then after that, I am going to follow up with my emails and my broadcasts. And that's how I have been getting 20 leads every single day for a good solid 3 months. And I hope this has been helpful. I will be passing this information on to Franco, and hopefully he feels it's good enough to put inside of our Simple Freedom Academy. And I hope this has been something that you can really enjoy because I've enjoyed doing it.